If you've been using GitHub for a while, you might have noticed that using your username and password to make commits and push into repo no longer works. This is because as of August 13, 2021, GitHub no longer accepts password authentication for operations. There are actually a few good reasons for doing this, such as the dangers of having passwords being reused from multiple websites. So you might be thinking, what does GitHub want me to use instead? The answer is token-based authentication. There are a few different options like SSH keys, personal access keys, and using OAuth. SSH keys are arguably the easiest to implement, so we'll focus today on using this method. We should probably talk about what's so great about SSH keys. The main reason is security. GitHub doesn't need your username and password each time when using SSH keys. Essentially, each key uniquely identifies your computer, and after initial setup, GitHub can trust that this computer can do operations. The key is sort of like your government-issued ID. There's a bit of an initial work to get your identification card. But after that, everyone who sees your ID just assumes you are who you say you are. Another nice thing about using SSH keys is that you can revoke a specific key. Since you set up a key for each computer or machine you use, by revoking a specific key, you can make sure a compromised computer, like a stolen one, won't impersonate you. And lastly, GitHub will actually remove your inactive SSH keys after a year. This is a great default for when you switch computers and never got around to manually revoking that key. All right, now that we have a little bit more background, let's go ahead and show how to create and use SSH keys. Assuming you haven't made any SSH keys before, the first step will be to generate a key. We'll need to open up a terminal on our computer, similar to this one. We'll then need to enter the command ssh-keygen-ted-25519, and then -c, with our email. In this case, I'm just calling it temp@example.com, since it doesn't really matter, but you would put your own email that you'd have for your GitHub profile. Note that this SSH key gen is saying how we're going to generate the key. This dash T and then the ED25519 is the type of encryption we'll use for that key. Note that if you have an older computer or your computer is not compatible with this encryption, you can instead use RSA. There's more details in the GitHub documentation linked in the description box. And then finally, we have dash C here, which is basically just saying, okay, here's the email associated with that key, which is why you put your own email and not temp@example.com. When I run this, this generates a new SSH key that we can now use. You'll be given this prompt asking you where you want to save your key. You can simply press enter to use the default location. You'll now also be prompted to type a secure passphrase. This is optional and you can skip it by pressing enter, but if you want the extra security, you should enter it now. If you do use a passphrase, you can have your Mac or Windows system save it in the keychain, so you don't have to retype it every single time. Maybe we can go over that in the future, but for now, press enter to skip this passphrase. Now that you have the key generated, we need to make sure our computer's SSH agent knows about it. You can sort of think of the agent as your wallet to hold your different SSH keys. We can start up the SSH agent by typing out eval, and then quotes, double quotes, $, parentheses, SSH-agent, --s, and parentheses, and quotes. Note this is just going to start up our SSH agent. Note that your system might be a little different, so if that command didn't quite work, definitely check out GitHub's guide. Now we can add our private key to the SSH agent. Think of it as putting our ID into our wallet. If you have a Mac, you might need to see if this file already exists. The file is from the /.ssh/config. If this file does exist already, we can just go ahead and open it. But in this case, this file doesn't exist, so we'll go ahead and create that by simply just typing touch and then the name of the file. In this case, again, that tilde, say it's the home directory .ssh/config. Now that the file is there, we can go ahead and edit it. I'll go ahead and use Vim here. Note that since we created this file and because it didn't exist before, it's completely blank. So we'll go ahead and enter this information from scratch. To add our private key to the SSH agent, we'll go ahead and type the following. We'll say host star, and then add keys to agent, yes. And then the name of the file, basically our key here. So that's going to be our identity file /id ed25519. And again, you might have something slightly different if you had a different process, but this file would actually exist inside the .ssh folder, assuming, of course, the Mac. Note that this last bit here is actually generated when we created the key. If we use the passphrase and want it to be stored so we don't have to type it every time, we can use max keychain by adding the following line, which is use keychain. Yes. Note if you're on Windows, you shouldn't have to create or populate the file. But since we're not using a passphrase, I'm going to go ahead and delete this line. And we'll go ahead and save this file. And the last part is just simply running ssh-add and then the name of that file, which in that case is the .ssh/id_ed25519. Awesome, looks like this worked. So the next step is to tell GitHub about our SSH key that's being used by our computer. So we'll go ahead and switch gears away from our terminal and go into a browser and open up github.com. While logged into our GitHub account, we'll go ahead and navigate to the settings. Then we'll go ahead and scroll down and look on the sidebar here until we find SSH and GGP keys. We'll click on that and we'll see that we'll have a new area called SSH keys. We'll go ahead and click on new SSH key. On this page, you'll see that there's a title and a key and something to explain to what we're going to put in this box. The title is just for us, basically just telling us what kind of SSH key we're using. And the key is going to actually come from the file that we generated when creating our key. So let's go ahead and open up that file. Now that we're in the terminal, I'll go ahead and use the cat command to read out the contents of the file. And the file name is the /.ssh, that's where the folder is. And then the file name is ID, and then the encryption name encryption type we use, ed25519.pub. The .pub is the important part, representing the public key. I'll go ahead and copy these contents here. And remember that this is just what's inside the file. So you could have opened this up in a text editor if you wanted to. And then we'll go back to our browser. We'll go ahead and paste the contents of that file under the key, and then we'll give it a meaningful name. In this case, I'll just call this tutorial key, since I'm not going to be keeping this key around. Then we can just simply add SSH key, and you'll likely be asked for your password. And that's it. In theory, you should be all set, but let's go ahead and test and see if it worked. We'll go back to a terminal and simply enter SSH-T git@github.com. This is basically just going to say, hey, I'm going to use my SSH key to try to access github.com. GitHub kind of has this as a practice to make sure that your connection actually works. You may get a warning something like this, since this is the first time we've actually connected. We'll go ahead and say yes. Then we should see a success. Right here, you can see you've successfully authenticated, but GitHub does not support show access, and that's what we expected. We just wanted to check that our SSH key worked. And in this case, it looks like it did work. So now we can go ahead and use that when we do our clones, our pushes, and all that good stuff. Let's go ahead and show you what you would need to do this. Let's go ahead and show how we can use our SSH key to do something like a clone. We'll go ahead and go to a repo here. In this case, it's one of my own repos. And I'll go ahead and click on this code part, which is what you normally would use to find your URL to clone. But you'll see that there's an HTTPS, SSH, and GitHub CLI. We're not going to use CLI right now, and HTTPS is what we used to use. We're going to use SSH. And you can see here, this part right here is a little bit different. And you can see at the very beginning it has git@github.com versus the HTTPS in the front here. So we'll go ahead and copy this. And then in our terminal, we'll go ahead and paste that link. And in our terminal, we'll go ahead and go do git clone, and then paste that link. And you can see here, it clones this. At this point, your repo that you've cloned onto your local machine will now know to use the SSH key. Note that if you are using a repo that was using an HTTPS key before instead of an SSH, you'll have to make sure your remote points to something like git at github.com versus the HTTPS. So if I were to go ahead and CD into this, I'll go ahead into lesson git. If I do git remote dash v, you can see here the origin, and this is the URL. Note again, if you did remote on a previous repo, you would have to update the remote. And there you go, that's it. We went through the main steps of getting SSH keys working. There's more tweaking and customizing you can do, but I hope this is a good, helpful start. Best of luck, and until next time, happy coding.